My name's Kate Stern. I'm a fertility specialist. I am the head of the endocrine and metabolic service at the Royal Women's Hospital, and I'm a senior fertility specialist and clinical director at Melbourne IVF. In my role, particularly at the Royal Women's in the endocrine and metabolic service, we see many women who have weight-related fertility issues, as well as women that have fertility issues and weight issues. And so it's a subject close to my heart. I'm sure you're all very well aware of the impact that being overweight has on fertility and reproductive health, as well as general health. So I know that you're all very aware of the impact of weight on fertility and reproductive health. We know that one of the most important problems with being overweight is the metabolic consequence of that, in terms of a higher risk of late effects such as diabetes, heart disease, high blood pressure, etc. In the medium term, being overweight is associated commonly with a condition called polycystic ovarian syndrome. Now, polycystic ovarian syndrome is a hormonal condition. It's a metabolic condition in which there is an elevation of the androgens, often associated with irregular cycles or amenorrhea or even anovulation. And often there is increased hirsutism, and women present with anovulatory infertility or oligoovulatory infertility. Now, the primary defect here, as you know, is a metabolic one, that the body requires more insulin to get the sugar into cells. And so patients develop hyperinsulinemia, which then, via a variety of little proteins, will have metabolic impact on the reproductive cycle. And so the cycles become erratic with increased levels of the abnormal hormones and irregular cycles. So one of the keys to the management of polycystic ovarian syndrome is weight management. And you know, people roll their eyes. You know what it's like. Patients come and see you and they're defensive. They know the first thing you're going to talk to them about is weight. And so one of the ways to approach PCOS weight issues is to focus on the absolute effect of weight on fertility, not on general health. They don't want to hear about general health. They already know all of that. And so we talk about how even very small fluctuations in weight in women who have a genetic predisposition can make their cycles erratic. We talk about how exercise can help this, because a lot of what happens to insulin happens in the muscle. And patients almost sort of visibly relax when they understand that there is a scientific validity to me talking about weight loss in terms of their cycles. We say, we really need you to do exercise. We need you to do some resistance exercise and some aerobic exercise. And we know that doing that exercise will make you more sensitive to insulin. So your insulin will drop and it will help your cycles. There is very good evidence that it is the exercise as well as the weight loss which contributes to improving the cycles. And it's sort of amazing. You know, these women will come markedly overweight. You'll encourage them to work hard on their exercise for the sake of their cycles. And when they achieve a relatively little weight loss, even 5 or 10 kgs, their cycles will regulate. And that is great positive reinforcement for these patients, because they come to see you, they know they've got PCOS, they've looked it up on all the websites, they feel like they're going to have a terrible life, it's beyond their control. And when they know that an achievable weight loss will help their ovulation, they feel much more optimistic and they feel it's so realistic to even try. And then they get the benefit of trying and seeing their cycles regulate. So with patients with PCOS, I talk about weight loss as being part of their medical treatment, an important part of their medical treatment. You know, I always say to them, I know you're really sick of people talking to you about weight loss everywhere you go. You've got infertility, you're feeling sad, you're trying to do everything already. But I'm talking to you not about weight loss for your general life. I'm talking about how a small amount of weight loss, as well as helping your general health and your long-term future, will make a big impact on your fertility. And you know, sometimes that approach will work. You know that not one approach will, the same approach will not work for everyone. So once we get these women on board that it is achievable to lose a bit of weight and that that will really help fertility, and I have to say this is a great time to harness enthusiasm from women because we get that motivation of them really wanting to conceive, which is an added motivation. What we have to do is help women to work out strategies. We can't just say, yeah, we really want you to lose weight, see you soon. So we talk about the sorts of exercise that are required. We talk about the available programs in the community. And we need to have some follow-up and say, okay, so we're going to meet in a month and talk about how it's going. And let's try and sort of get you exercising 3 times a week for 30 minutes in the next month. And you're going to do one gym, one walking, and maybe one swim or one walk with a girlfriend, but you're walking fast and you can hardly talk. And then let's see how we're going. And we give them information about where to seek help. I think you've got to explain why you want to do it. You've got to harness that motivation. And then you've got to provide some assistance with the opportunities, especially women from low socioeconomic class who are not going to have ready availability of cash to go to the gym. So the message really is you just got to keep fighting the good fight. You can't just sort of feel despair, the same despair your patients feel when they walk into your office. You've got to keep the momentum up, the enthusiasm, your belief that the patient will be able to achieve this. And that's, I think, one of the hardest things, really, because as doctors, we've seen patients come in time and time again, and they just can't move the weight. So I think we've just got to keep that enthusiasm, and our patients will sense it. And with the right education and opportunities for help, you usually get there.